communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
Today we offer the Holy Mass for Dorothy's care, and we remember also in particular Paul and Anne Fador, and we celebrate the memory of Saint Philip Neri, a very joyful, almost a comedian, that he was able to bring the faith to, especially to young people in Rome, with a lot of laughter, a lot of joy. So we prepare ourselves today to celebrate the Holy Eucharist, and with humility we come to the presence of the Lord and recognize him our sins. So together we say, I confess to Almighty God
and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and in what I have failed to do, through my most grievous fault. Therefore, I ask Blessed Mary, ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Let us pray. O God, who will never cease to bestow the glory of holiness on the faithful servants you raise up for yourself, graciously grant that the Holy Spirit may kindle in us that fire with which he wonderfully filled the heart of Saint Philip Neri. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the Acts of the Apostles. Paul, having traveled throughout Greece, was eager to be in Jerusalem, if possible, on the day of Pentecost. From Miletus, he sent a message to Ephesus, asking the elders of the church to meet him. When the elders came to him, Paul said to them, "You yourselves know how I lived among you the entire time, from the first day that I set foot in Asia, serving the Lord with all humility and with tears, enduring the trials that came to me through the plots of the Jews. I did not shrink from doing anything helpful, proclaiming the message to you and teaching you publicly and from house to house, as I testified to both Jews and Greeks about repentance towards God and faith towards our Lord Jesus. And now, as a captive to the Spirit, I am on my way to Jerusalem, not knowing what will happen to me there, except that the Holy Spirit testifies to me in every city that imprisonment and persecutions are waiting for me. But I do not count my life of any value to myself, if only I may finish my course and the ministry that I receive from the Lord Jesus to testify to the good news of God's grace. And now I know that none of you among whom I have gone about proclaiming the kingdom will ever see my face again. Therefore I declare to you this day that I am not responsible for the blood of any of you, for I did not shrink from declaring to you the whole purpose of God." The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Sing to God, O King. of the earth.
Sing to God, O kingdoms of the earth.
Reign in abundance, O God. You showered abroad. You restored your heritage when it languished. Your flock found a dwelling in it. In your goodness, O God, you provided for the needy.
Sing to God, O kingdoms of the earth.
Blessed be the Lord who delivers us up. God is our salvation. Our God is a God of salvation. And to God the Lord belongs escape from death.
Sing to God, O kingdoms of the earth.
Alleluia. All the feathers. Then she came back and says, I never see him with chickens without feathers. And Philip said, I give you the absolution, but after you have to go back the same road and pick up all the feathers that you have unplucked from the chicken. And I can't, you know, the wind is going to blow them away. So you see, when you criticize, when you judge, when you talk badly about people, that's what happens. It's like those feathers. They go in the wind, you can never bring them back. So she got the double lesson. Like I said, he is the founder of Oratorians, a group of interesting people who preach missions. And I like it because our faith is a faith full of joy. You know, I'm sure that even Jesus himself had a lot of fun with his disciples. And so at the same time, we had to present our faith in the best way, the most joyful way. And I want to give you one word from the Gospel today, which I think is very beautiful and is repeated many times during this time before Pentecost. It says, Holy Father, protect them in your name that you have given me, so that they may be one as we are one. Unity, to be together, that's one of the clear signs of the disciples of Jesus. Unity is, I'd say, the basic value, basic virtue of the community of Christians. And we don't talk only about unity between the Protestant, the Catholics, the Evangelists, or Presbyterians, no. Even that, but before that, unity inside the community. That's the great sign that Jesus is present. When there is unity, there is Jesus. When there is no Jesus, there is no unity. So let us pray that the Holy Spirit may bring to us this great gift of unity. Join together in faith, we turn our hearts to God as we present our petitions to Him.
For Pope Francis, may God fill his heart with joy and wisdom as he guides the people and leads the church. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those who have made an enforced loss, may the grace of the Holy Spirit help them to carry out their duties with love and respect for all his people. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those who are sad or burdened, may the intercession of St. Philip Neri, whom we memorialize today, help bring them out of their sorrow to find joy and laughter again. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For members of this community, may the Lord who prayed for us help us in our prayers for one another. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those who have died, may they rejoice in the presence of the risen Lord. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Let us pray for Thanksgiving. Sorry, for the deceased member, Dorothy Scale, for whom this Mass is offered. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Let us pray for all our parishioners and all the people who are going through difficulties with coronavirus, who is homebound, who are hospitalized, that Lord in His mercy will heal them, protect them, and bring peace in their life. And let us ask the Lord to stop the spreading of this virus. For this we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Let us pray for our special petitions. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Father, hear our prayers which we offer with confidence and faith. Yes, this through your Son Jesus, who is Lord forever and ever.
Amen.
Blessed are you, Lord God, all creation. For goodness we have this bread to offer. Which earth has given the human hands have made, it will become for us the bread of life. Blessed are you, Lord God, all creation. For goodness we have this bread to offer. Fruit of the vine and the work of human hands, it will become our spiritual drink.
Blessed Joseph.
glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen.
And the same is the matter for my divine teaching, we dare to say,
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name, thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Amen.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days. By the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles, peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church. And graciously grant our peace and unity in accordance with your will, live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
So the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit. Let us offer each other the sign of peace.
Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world.
Have mercy on us.
Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world.
Have mercy on us.
Lamb of God, you take away the sins. Behold the Lamb of God, behold who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
The Lord, Lord.
prayer of spiritual communion. My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the most holy sacrament. I love you above all things and I desire to receive you in my soul. Since I cannot at this moment receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. I embrace you as if you were already there and unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. Amen. The Memorare. Remember, O most gracious Virgin Mary, that never was it known that anyone who fled to thy protection, implored thy help, or sought thy intercession, was left unaided. Inspired by this confidence, I fly unto thee. O virgins of virgins, my mother, today do I come before thee, I stand sinful and sorrowful. O mother of the world incarnate, despise not my petitions, but in thy clemency, hear and answer me. Amen.
Let us pray. Having fed upon these heavenly delights, we pray, O Lord, that in imitation of St. Philip, we may always long for that food by which we truly live. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your
spirit. Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go in peace, glorifying the Lord by your life.
Thanks be to God.
Prayer to St. Michael. St. Michael, the Archangel, defend us in battle.